Here we are here to talk about adoption process, implications and perceptions in India. So everybody knows what adoption is. So adoption means a legal process. It's a legal process which allows someone to become a parent of one child. Now, who is eligible for adoption? Let us look at the process. Parents who are physically and mentally, emotionally stable, couple who do not have their biological child, single female is eligible to adopt child of any age. So if the lady comes and says, I want to adopt a child, and she's not married, or she's married and she's still single, she's eligible to adopt the child of any gender. She doesn't have any restrictions that she has to adopt only a girl or a boy. A single male person, like if a guy who wants to adopt a child, he cannot adopt a girl child. He has to adopt a male gender only. In case of a couple, the consent of both the spouses is required for adoption. Now, if one of the spouses is saying no, then again the social worker has to speak to them, and only if they're still agreeing, they can go in for adoption. No child will be given in adoption to a couple unless until they have completed 2 years of stable marital relationship. Now, many of the times they will come only after 5 or 6 or 7 or 8 years, because they have tried all kinds of things in before that. Nowadays we have such lovely assistive reproductive technologies which have come into the world, and they have tried everything. And only because they want to have their own children, and which if they cannot have due to all kinds of reasons, then they will come in for adoption. But we have to see that their marital status is very stable. They should not have issues with each other. Minimum age difference between the child and the parent should not be less than 25 years of age. So you cannot adopt, suppose a couple is very young and they want to adopt a bigger child, you can't do that. Couple with more than 3 children will not be considered. Suppose you already have biological 3 children and then you want more child, I think you are not doing justice to the others who don't even have one. I would always say, if you have 2 also, don't go in for adoption. Let us give priority to somebody who does not have even one child. It's very difficult for them as well. How to adopt a child? It is mandatory to register online as per Adoption Regulation Act 2017. Now let us go to the many years before. We could just go to an agency, that is SA or RIPA, and go register in the agency, and they were the ones who were registering, and they would look at, like in Goa, we could go to Mother Teresa, Matru Chaya, we have Caritas, and we could register there. The couples could register directly themselves, and then the process would start, the homes study and all these things. But from 2000, CARA, this is the Central Adoption Resource Authority, made it mandatory that online registrations should happen. So now you just have to fill the form online. If you're unable or not familiar about how to register online, you can approach the District Child Protection Officer. We have a DCP of your district, or the adoption social worker. Now, adoption social worker cannot be simply anybody. That person has to have the MSW degree. You cannot simply go to person who's calling himself. You have to, that degree has to be there. A person has to have a stamp, like I have a registered stamp, so that the person is proper and who can do in the adoption process. Key points to remember for prospective adoptive parents. Now, whoever wants to adopt, what should they remember? Only adopt from specialized adoption agencies recognized by the government. Do not approach any nursing home or hospitals or maternity homes, unauthorized institutions or individuals for adoption. Keep away from touts, middlemen in adoption. They will mislead you to adopt a child illegally. There was a case last year in which a couple had adopted a child from Pune. Adopted in the sense they purchased it, I would say, from a lady who was ready to give in for adoption. Now, there was a mistake that they had done. Number one, the lady had no one. So she was married earlier, but the husband had left her. So finally she had to look after this child, which she could not due to her ill health. So she decided to give in for adoption. The mistake that happened was she did not sign a relinquishment form, which is very, very important. If you are giving a child of yours to in adoption, you have to have a proper relinquishment form, which you relinquish the child, and legally you say that I am relinquishing this child and I won't have any further rights on this. And then it has to go to a proper agency, and through CARA online, this child has to go to an agency, the child, then the CWC papers have to come in. So there is a lot of formalities that happen. You simply cannot go and adopt. Now this couple, because they thought that they could pay money, they gave her some money. Finally, they brought the child, and the child was in Vasco. This has happened in Goa. The child was in Vasco, and then finally, this guy, whoever her husband was, he came back, and there was a lot of issue. It went. This couple were in the police station in Mapsa, and the child was just left haywire because that mother also was in the police. So this case was brought out even on in Goa. And that time also we had to speak up. This was happened by, I don't know who had done this, but they themselves. There is another couple who had come suddenly one day and asked me, how can I adopt without all this paperwork? If you know some child, just give it to us. I said, I don't know any child like this because I don't work in such agencies. You can go and register online now, and you will have to go through, because online there are so many options available. There was a time when there are, like, you have to go to the agency, yet we had a whole home study being done, the questions being asked and everything, and very formally, very legally things have been happening. So please do not, if you know whoever wants to adopt, please do not allow anybody to go and talk to any middleman, because number one, the child, whoever has been adopted, biologically, if the mother claims that child, the child at any age can be claimed by the mother. The child will have to go back to that mother only.
Even if she signed the relinquishment form?
Relinquishment sign, no problem. And it has to be legal. Again, you have to legalize. There has to be an adoption deed done.
Do the people who manage this, do they also examine the person who is giving away the child, relinquishing it?
Yeah, we'll come get the questions later. So, there are a lot more things that you will have to ask me. Who will help you for adoption process? A competent court, Central Adoption Resource Authority, that is CARA, State Adoption Resource, that is SARA. Then we have recognized Indian Placement Agency, that is REPA. REPA is doing international adoptions, and the other one will do the Indian adoptions. Then we have special adoption agencies, and then we have adoption coordinating agencies as well. Okay, please go through to this. Now this is this print has not come very nicely, but the first one, what is the process of adopting a child? Online registration, that is at CARA. If you open the CARA website, C, capital A, capital R, capital A. Open the website, and everything is very clearly mentioned on that. There is an online adoption form which you can fill in, and you fill in, upload all the documentations and everything. Now, once you do that, there is a person, they will tell you, okay, there's an agency and whichever state you are. Now, they will also allocate you the person who will do your home study. Now, this person only will be coming to do your home study. So, the agency will tell you who will come, or the Department of Women and Child Welfare will tell you who will come to do your home study. Nobody else can come and do your home study and tell you all kinds of things. Only that person will take all your documentation. Whatever the person asks, you have to provide with the documentation. Provide the Xeroxes, number of certificates. They will also help you to put it in proper format. And after that, now in CARA, what happens is the adoption social worker will take all the details. They will make a report on that, and that report again, the agency will have to upload it. Okay, so that's the work of the social worker. Now the social worker is a person who goes to the house and also in the agency, and we'll be helping to upload. Now what happens is the social worker will know exactly how these parents are, whether they are good enough to be parents, whether they have a good family, what kind of behavior pattern they have, either this person is sick or not sick, or sometimes there was a woman who had come and she had a diabetes report of almost 500 and something, and she insisted, "I want to adopt." Her husband was abroad and he had given her a power of attorney. This was many years ago, and she said, "I have to adopt, I have no children." In her case, we could not give her a child because she herself was so sick that anything can happen to her in that case, and who is going to be looking after the child? So we have to also think about. Then there was another case wherein, so the homes, the social worker had to say no. So she was very annoyed with the social worker. The second case was this lady and claimed that all the house and everything, she gave a fake picture, the house was hers and everything. But when the papers were called in, everything belonged to her mother and her sisters and all that, and she had built a place there, but there was no legal things. I said, "Tomorrow, if you anything happens to you, this house will not be yours, it will be the mother's and the sister's. What will the child do?" See, there is no need that a person has to have money or something like that, but whatever he or she has, it should be for him, and like your own biological children, it should be also going to that child, whoever you adopt. Because otherwise the child is going to suffer very badly in future. You cannot let, just because you are adopting a child, you cannot let the child suffer, whether you are there or not there. So you have to be very careful of it. So the social worker's duty, prime duty, is to say, number one, behavior. But what if this couple has some issue mentally? What if they have AIDS or something and they want to adopt? Because they have a lot of property, but they both have it, so they will adopt, so something will go to the child. No. So, or what if they are going to get a property, or in the will, it is, there was a couple, in the will it was written, when you have a child, this property will come to you. And this couple adopted, we had to go to the court and bring the child back later. Because this couple went away, after all the property or everything went away, they went abroad and the child was left at a mercy with somebody else. So you can't do all these things. That's why the home study report has to be very proper. Then the third point, how to go about the process, is profiling. The PAPs, that is the adoptive parents, whoever are asking, based on the child of eligibility, are referred their profile of legally free children. So the child should be legally free. In the sense, it has to have a clearance from CWC. CWC means Child Welfare Committee. Child Welfare Committee, once it gives an order, that yes, now this child is legally free for adoption, the Child Welfare Committee plays a role in this. Whenever a child is kept in any agency or an orphanage, not all orphanages have the right to give in for adoption, but whenever a child is placed in an agency, then the agency's duty, for if the child is a infant, just born, for first 3 months, nothing can be done, only the child is looked after. We have doctors who will help and come visit the agency. They look after the child and check everything. When the child is healthy enough, they will go to the CWC and ask for a clearance paper that now no one has come for this child and there's no issue. Can we have, and we have a relinquishment. If there is a relinquishment, or there is, if there is no relinquishment, if the child is found, we have to put it in the official gazette, which we have done many a times. We have to put it in the police. We have to put it if anybody is coming to claim the child. So in 3 months, no one has come, the child is still there. CWC will give us a clearance. And once the clearance is there, then the child is said clear for legal adoption. So after all this, then only the child will be referred to this couple. Now the fourth thing is reservation. That's the fourth point. PAPs reserve a child within 48 hours. Means what? On CARA website, now it's so nice. Earlier, whenever, whichever agency you went, whatever the children were there from the agency, that was one child was shown to the parent. Now CARA has, suppose you're putting up your profile on CARA, CARA will give you 3 states to choose from. So suppose somebody's chosen Karnataka, Goa and Gujarat. So 2 children from each state, from any of those agencies which are cleared and suitable to this parent, will be shown to this parent. Within 48 hours, they have to select one particular child, and that child will be, now there is selection. Earlier, this was not there. So one child will be selected, and that parent has to go to that particular agency, then the process starts further. The fifth one is matching. Matching of PAPs with the child is done by the adoption committee within 20, 29 or 20 days. So acceptance. Acceptance of the child by the PAPs and taking the child in pre-adoption foster care. Now, once the parents accept it, they can take in pre-adoption foster care in the sense for few days until the legal paperwork is done. Either the child remains in the agency that you don't have to take the child, or you take in and then the whole paperwork. So it depends on the agency, and but CARA has very strict rules that they will see that the paperwork is done. Then the seventh point is petition filing. We will have to file the petition. Who files is the agency will file it, and the co-petitioner is designated at the court, and within 10 days of acceptance this is done. Court order, then the court order by disposing of the case within 60 days. So within 60 days the court will give an order, and there will be a camera hearing. So there will be a camera hearing in the court, and the court will ask you questions to the parent. The court will directly ask questions. There are questions which are asked directly. I don't know, many of you, some of you all are here, they might know what questions. So the court will ask you why a girl child only, or why a boy only, or why did you come in for adoption? Anything they will like to ask you. So after the court order, then the birth certificate order. The court will give you an order to make the birth certificate. Now it will be in your name. Earlier, whatever the birth certificate is there will be in whatever the agency, depending if it's relinquished, then that mother's name will be there. Depending on if the child has been given by a couple because they cannot afford it, then those parents' name. So the birth certificate will have to change. Now the birth certificate will be made only by the court order and whosoever name. Now suppose I have adopted, so my name as a mother will come, my husband's name as a father will come, and the child's name, whatever name we want to give the child, correct name can be made, and this properly has, that order has to be given to the birth certificate office, and they make it and they give it to you immediately without any trouble. Now then the post adoption follow up is a most important thing, because people think adoption done, fine, we don't have to talk to this woman, whoever. People have even not received my calls after they have taken the child, not even shown me their faces, they don't even know who I am. They won't hello the minute they see me in some place, and they'll run away somewhere. And before that, 20,000 calls, day, night, everything. But after that, they don't know me. But it's okay. But they don't forget that there is a follow-up which we have to do. For 2 years, we have to follow up. Simple reason is we have to see whether the child and the parent are bonding well. We have no other intention. Whether the couple is happy with the child they have taken, whether there's an issue between both of them and the couple and this child are not able to cope up with each other. There are other reasons also. So we have to go do the follow-ups all the time. And CARA has certain rules that we have to report these follow-ups. The couple refuses to give photographs and the details of the child. It's very difficult, yes. I have to keep asking them, can I have the photo now of this? They'll give the first one only. No. 6 months later, the child is looking different. I have to give a different photo and the parent's photo again with the child and the report of how and what the child is doing and what is happening. We have to present this report to CARA, because if you are, we as social, we have duty to follow. Okay, so this is the second part. Now, frequently asked questions. Can we get details like caste, date of birth, time of birth of the child? Is there a minimum income level for a parent to be eligible to adopt a child? Is it compulsory for an adoptive parent to transfer property to the adoptive child? Are there any age restrictions for parents to be eligible for adoption? Can a person of any religion and caste adopt? Are differently abled, the spelling is wrong, couples eligible to adopt a child? Can we adopt relatives' child? Can parents with biological children adopt a child? Do we have to inform the child that he or she is adopted? I have the answers for this. Details like caste, date of birth, not required, please. They are children of God. Why do you need all these things? The adoption regulations 2017 does not specify minimum income levels in adoption eligibility criteria. However, conducting the income study, the social worker will assess the capability and motivation of prospective adoption family to provide reasonable living standards to a child. I have given children to people who are nice, a couple whose salary was 3,000 a month. It doesn't matter. The couple had, they were having ancestral house which they were staying in. At least there was a shelter. And the couple was poor and still we could give the child to them. There's nothing like that we cannot give a child. Only thing I asked them, the child's expense will be a little more now because the child will be coming in. Now the child is not your biological child, so giving it milk and all these things, the parents said we'll do anything to do make the child healthy and happy. So that was what we look at. As per the definition of adoption, an adopted child is a lawful child of the adoptive parents. Please remember, because legal paperwork is done, with the same rights, privileges, responsibilities as that of a biological child. So nothing like that. If the child is saying, if you feel that adopted children don't get anything, if they are legally adoption is done, they will get everything what is belonging to their parents. Yes, there are no restrictions based on caste, religion under JJ Act 2015. Of course, there is a different religion with Muslims may have, they have in their law that you don't adopt and all these things. That depends on them. But like this, there is no. Yes, differently abled couples are eligible to adopt also, depending on the nature and extent of their disability. So if they have a problem with their health, they still can go in for adoption, but they should be, you know, able enough to handle the child. While preparing the home study, the social worker would assess whether the prospective adopter has the support required for parenting. Suppose this disabled couple want to adopt, then they should have that support from their parents or sisters or brothers to help them out in this journey. Yes, if you are a child's paternal uncle or aunt or maternal uncle or aunt or paternal grandparent or maternal grand, then you may adopt as per section 51 and 53 of Adoptions Regulations Act 2017. So legally in family also you can give in the child, but you have to follow these rules. So simply because I have an extra baby, okay, you don't have one, you take it and there's no paper made. Please see that there is a proper paperwork in this. Now, age of children and the composite age of parents. Anybody can just not stand up and say, I want to adopt. If it depends on the age. Now, up to 90 years, composite ages, 45 years, one parent should be. So, 90 years together, they can adopt up to 4 years, that is 0 to 4. Now, 0 is difficult. With CWC, it should be about 3 months. Above 4 and 8 years, they should be at least 100 years old together. Okay? And above 8 and 18 years. So if you want to even adopt an 18 year old, you can adopt, but your composite ages should be 110. So, and the
age changed because it was 70 or 60.
Yeah, yes,
before, right?
yes. It was different and they keep, see what happens, CARA will see, because age wise they will give you a bit more preference. They have a study now, so we keep going in for more studies and we meet up. See, we all meet up, the home study people, the social workers, the agencies, we all meet up and then we are asked questions, or we can even mail them questions of what can be done, or researches we can mail them. These are the things that are needed now. So we try and give, because there are so many kids, you know. Let me tell you, right now, under us in Goa itself, we have around 78 institutions and they have so many children. But only 2 are adoption agencies. So what happens to all those children now? Some of them have single parents, some of them have no parents. I know of so many children who are orphaned and just sitting in those agencies. They're 9 years old, they're 12 years old, they're 14. Who's going to adopt them? What do we do with these children? So many a times, I am the one, I like in Mother Teresa and many other institutions, without telling them, I go help them out to go for further studies, whatever money that we collect, I put it for them so that they are sponsored, their education is done, or some of them, I've got at least 6 of them married. So trying our level best to do whatever we can do. So, you know, these bigger children don't get adopted. Nobody wants a bigger child. They want to, you know, go, this is my baby, I want to go with a bigger, smaller baby all the time. a new beginning. Yes, family with biological children can adopt. Couples with three or more children shall not be considered for adoption except in the case of adoption of special needs children. Now, these children who are having special needs, they never get adopted again. And three, I have seen that they need three no's from our Indian families. So another foreigner, usually foreign nationals, adopt these children. It's really sad that our people don't want to take any responsibility of these things. So if there is another child like this, and if you have three, only then this child will be given in for adoption. It is suggested that parents introduce the word adoption as early as possible so that it becomes a comfortable part of the child's vocabulary. It is advisable that you as parents be the first to inform your child that she or he is adopted, but determine how and when. There have been case studies saying that yes, you should tell a little later and all, but I have the experience of so many and a lot more cases who we have spoken to. We all agree that it should be told as when they are small, as small as possible, where they are able to understand. Please tell them beforehand so that, and make it so comfortable that they never feel anything bad at all. And this word, why to make it like a taboo, you know? So it's not right. Just tell them it's adoption, it's beautiful, it's nice. You, just because I didn't have a child, I have the privilege of having you as my child. It's so wonderful, actually. Do we have to inform the school about the child, that the child is adopted? Many people have this question. Now we have, our child is going to the school, should we inform? There's no need. Do we have to disclose the information about adoption when the child gets married? Can the adopted child know about his or her roots? If there are adjustment problems and behavioral issues with the child, can we return the child? It is not legal requirement to inform the school about it. It is advisable that this information be disclosed when the child gets married, especially because of genetic issues may come up. So just inform, because tomorrow, because marriage is an institution which is based on faith and truth, I think we should have a clear picture that, you know, it should be whatever is there, you tell it. Tomorrow the marriage should not break up because you have not informed us. And also people's acceptability again. Yes, the adoptive child may seek information about his or her rules. As per Regulation 44 of Adoption Regulations 2017, information may be inquired from SAR or CWC of the district from where the child was adopted. However, not every child expresses the need to meet their biological parents. I have a lot of people who have come, who have grown up, and they have been trying to trace their parents. Now, it is a very difficult situation how a person has relinquished in what, under what circumstances, and then this parent, this child to go and see that parent, or that parent has to agree to meet the child. So it's a big emotional thing, and we have to prepare. So we need a lot more counselors in this. I try as much as possible, because it's a whole situation that you're going to meet a mother or a father who's relinquished you. And for what reason? So it's a big thing, that what's going, the trauma that goes into the whole thing. Well, in such a situation, you may seek help, professional counseling or contact, and shall first arrange counseling for adoptive parents and adopters as linked to them to counseling centers set up at the authority or state agency. Try not to go homes and all, try to set up at agencies. If these counseling sessions do not solve the problem, and if it is in best interest of it to terminate the adoption. Now, this is for the other one. If the parent and the child is, you know, has to go back, like the adoptive child has been taken and there has been an issue, and we have to take back the adoptive child, or the parent says, now there has been a case in Bangalore recently that the parents could not handle this, they have one biological child and they took an elder girl. And this girl was quite big enough, and see, she's 12 years old. These parents had a 4-year-old biological child. They adopted a 12-year-old girl to get a bigger girl as a sister. And this girl now being 12, she's grown up in an institution for 12 years. These parents did not understand why she would write letters to her friends, or she was feeling different in their house. And within 1 and 2 months, they were not able to adjust. And they said, take her back and all that. So now the agency, you know, has to have these counseling sessions. It's a lot more going into it. Now they have taken the child back, but the child is, you know, it's very difficult for the child again back to go, because the agency, the children are laughing at her and saying, "Are they sent you back?" And you know, there's a lot more things happening. So people need a lot of counseling when they're adopting, when they're taking in to understanding level. If they don't understand, they should meet counselors. Very, very important. So, or 13.7 for in-country adoption, termination of adoption will depend on whether the adoption is still in adoption foster care stage, whether final stage order has been. Yeah, in the foster care stage, it is guardianship stage. The child knows that he is not adopted. It depends on how. So the child also has been counseled that, okay, you can now go and stay in this place, but we don't know. They're going to look after you for 2 years. Never tell the child that, okay, they're going to be your parents. So foster care also, the home study, and it's very important that the social worker plays a proper role in this. If the social worker tells that, no, these parents are definitely going to adopt you in 2 years' time, and if these parents are not able to adopt due to their own personal reasons, that also affects the child. So please, a lot of things happen. And inter-country, it's very difficult because to bring the whole process, because it's along with their embassy and their home study, and it's a lot more work and very difficult. These are the statistics, how it is going. The red is showing the inter-country adoption, and the blue is showing the in-country adoptions. From 6,000 to 2,000, it's going now slowly, very, very slowly. As whoever is applied in CARA, they know very well how slowly and how difficult it is becoming. As per Times of India report, in just over 2,000 children available for adoptions. You all know that a line of adoptions, the people who are waiting is huge. And 20,000 prospective parents are waiting and spilling over the years now. Huge number is just waiting. They're applying. The reason behind this dismal state can be attributed to the fact that most often kids are with the child care institutions which are not registered with the CARA. That is what I'm telling you. We have 78 institutions here. None of them want to register with CARA. I have no idea why. I mean, some of them can. We don't need all of them. They can be just institutions who look after the children or rehabilitation. But some can register. So that many more children will have a house to go to. So far, registration, as many as 4,000 child care institutions is still pending. Here also, we have to keep telling them. They don't even register. Some of the institutions that are here, they are not even registered properly under us only, under the GCA also. Over half the children available for adoption are girls, and still they are not adopted because they want only boys, mera beta kind of stuff. So statistically, we see that the number of parents waiting for adoptions are much more than the children in the orphanage registered for adoptions. According to UNICEF, India has more than 29.6 million abandoned and orphaned children. According to a study by Childline India Foundation, I am also a trustee of Childline Pune. And out of the 470,000 in institutionalized care, only a fraction find its way into a home. They get a family to have a home. Otherwise, all of them are still there, abandoned, orphaned, selling things on the street. Some of them don't even have any institution to go to. Institutions are given a pittance of 600 rupees per month for a child care. How can they run it? They are in dire straits, you know, people, they depend on other people then to give them things. I visit institutions when we have to raid and inspect them. And the saddened plight is I cannot say much there. We just have to inspect and raid. But you know, the plight that I see, that there are no pillow covers, there are no beds, and there are no mattresses, and we have many. We try and collect it and send it through somebody. So that's how we do whatever we can do. But you know, there are, these children can go in for adoptions. They can go into a home. But they have to register. And our government has to really push this to do these things. Most of the institutions aren't registered for adoptions. Consequences is most of the parents have exhausted all options. And yet there are children in institutions waiting for realization of a better future. Perceptions in India. According to the India Society of Assisted Reproduction, we have 27.5 million couples actively trying to conceive through various methods. We have a gynecologist within us, and he may tell us also that yes, we have so many people. Like, I have done my research in infertility, and every day I used to get so many calls saying that yes, madam, I'm married for so many years, I've done this, I've done that, I've done IVFs, I've done IUIs, I've done everything, but I still won't, I'm not conceiving. So many, just me alone, but so many people like me who have been getting this, and then so many, 20,000 parents in line waiting for adoptions. We have so many children there, still orphaned and abandoned. What can we do about this? The sad reality is 89% of the about 27.5 million know about adoption. Many people know about adoptions. 77 are even just positive, yes, we will go for adoption. But 54% out of this only show the willingness to go adopt. And finally, the sorry figure cuts down to just four numbers, like 4,000 adopted in the whole year, 3,000 only adoptions done in the whole year, when there are so many millions who are waiting to adopt and so many millions who are waiting to get adopted. The NCPR data clearly states that there are 5850 registered CCIs in India. If we register all the unregistered, our basket will be like 8,000. Acceptance, now what are the, why they don't go in for adoptions and so on. Number one, first of all, they don't want to tell only that we are infertile and we have problems, and they hide in the families only, and my father will say something, my mother will say something, my relatives will say something that she has no children and so many things, and why she has no children. Are it's normal. Societal approval, I am going to adopt. What will they think about me? What will they say to my adopted child? The adopted child bolega to problem. So societal approval. Feeling it is like a taboo topic and not going for counseling. Thoughts of hiding from relatives and friends that they don't want to adopt, so they'll hide and they'll not tell. So again, the process is like hidden. Not informing the child about his or her being adopted in fright that the child may run away. These are the perceptions. If I adopt and my child grows up and the child will run away to his parents, and then what we will do? So they don't want to go in for adoptions. Wanting their own lineage. I want my own child. I want to have my own biological, any which way, surrogate karu, kuch bhi karu, but mera bachcha. This is what, if they have to finally surrender to the word of adoption, making it difficult for all those who are helping also. So the people who are going to help them to go in for adoption, they'll make it difficult for them as well. Telling them all kinds of things. Wanting religion, caste, quality, genes in orphaned children for adoption. Can you believe this? They'll ask for what genes that child is whom we are going to adopt. How am I to know? How is the agency also to know? Misconception that these are available as per their choice. They have a misconception. Whatever they want, they will get it. I want a fair, very good looking, very cute looking child. You can't do like that. We don't print them. That adoptive children are not as good as biological children. And foster care, some of them think, I took under foster care, it's adoption, it's done, and they forget that there is a process after that. They just disappear. One character came, he took in for foster care, abhi mera ho gaya bachcha, he went off to America. Are, how are we supposed to connect with you? It's foster care. It becomes a human rights violation. You cannot take the child and go away. You have to be here and show us the baby. So lot of wrong things people do. Can we do something to shift this paradigm, the thought? Bring in awareness in society about adoptions. Create a better understanding about the need for a couple to go in for adoption. Apprehension when it comes to adopting children with special needs. We lot of apprehensions. If I tell that this child has a slight problem, like I had a child, a club foot. You know what is a club foot? The club foot was there and it could be repairable. So we went into with doctor, one of the doctors known here who would do the operation, and said it may come back also, it has a genetic issue. But I said right now the child, very good looking child, healthy looking child, just because of the club foot, nahi, isko problem hai, we cannot take this child, our family is not going to accept this child. So they refused the child. I am working with that baby all the time. A child had a slight, you have this a little cockish eye. No, this child is not looking good. I can't take this baby. They refuse children for this. We are very, very, very fair. we can't take this baby. But I have then three people said no. One inter-country couple came, they are fair only. They took away this Negro child. And the child is now, I think he's, how old is Willie?
17.
He is there, happy with the parents. So government to focus on shutting down unregistered agencies, running a countrywide campaign on adoptions, work towards child development, which we can do in registered institutions, moving the child on street into better institution. Whenever you see a child which is on the street, try to move it wherever you can, like Childline. Best is you call 1098, that is Childline number, and tell Childline that please help this child to move to an institution so that they can be taken care of. Making more institutions to move forward with foster care and adoptions. I think we had launched this in Goa, foster care, a long back, and it is going, but very, very slow. In the meeting also, I requested them, let us make it like many of the agencies to go in for foster care. At least many parents who are waiting, they can start having the children in their home, getting adjusted to this child. The child will see a home, how her home is. Because institutionalized, they don't even know how the world look outside in the night, because they're in the institutions, they're not allowed to go out at all in the evenings. So they don't really know what is to go with hand in hand with the parent for a movie or eat popcorns. They have no idea. So we need to bring about this awareness. Yeah. So now we'll take questions.